Welcome to She's Local TV. I'm Jen Maceda, where we connect you with relatable, accessible inspiration because we think local women are inspiring. Join us as we engage locally, inspire at home. She's Local.
Next up, meet Jen Gruber, the 2019 Metro West Conference for Women keynote speaker.
Focusing your keynote on your latest book, The More Method. So people that are not familiar, can you tell us how you came up with that method?
Yeah, so I created The More Method as a culmination of my 20 plus years of teaching human potential. And you did say, you know, we'd love to define that. So I'll define it now before I go any further. Human potential is the ability that we all have to expand who we are in all facets of our lives. So expand my potential as a businesswoman, expand my potential as a mother, expand my potential in my health and well-being and energy to thrive. There's so many facets of who we are and areas of our life that we can consistently expand. A lot of people stop pushing their level of potential when they graduate high school or college. And maybe we'll go get a certificate or some sort of training, but they're never really thinking, how much further can I expand who I am and what I'm truly capable of? And so I like to challenge everybody at any stage of life, in every aspect of life, to want to be the best, most expansive version of themselves. And so the More Method shares with people how to do that. And what really transpired for me in the last decade is the terminology emotional intelligence got a lot more trendy and cool, and people started to understand the true value and importance of it. As Harvard Business Review's front cover said a few years ago, it is the key ingredient to success. And it was an interesting time period for me and dynamic because earlier on, companies would say, no, we don't really need to learn that soft skill. And I'd say soft skill, it's an impact skill. It's the impact of everything.
The critical skill.
Yeah. So all of a sudden, it became really trendy really quick, which often brings a diluting of expertise, where a lot of people were jumping on this bandwagon saying they were teaching emotional intelligence, and they really weren't, or they were doing it in some very pared down form. And emotional intelligence is a very deep layered topic. And the way I was teaching it is a lot different than my counterparts, because if you look at, you know, Emotional Intelligence 2.0, which many people have already read, it is really talking about theory of being aware, theory of being emotionally aware. And there's a big difference between theoretically thinking about being empathetic and compassionate and an ability to let things go versus really being. And in all my studying of different disciplines from not just psychology and emotional intelligence being a component of that, but I used to be a national level fitness competitor, so I have a deep rooted background in physiology and nutrition, and neuroscience is my obsession, and epigenetics and quantum physics and metaphysics. So all of these disciplines that I'm consistently learning from, I kept pulling the elements together to how do you keep basically hacking and building the best version of yourself. And you can't just pick from one discipline. So as the emotional intelligence term started getting diluted from some people saying they were teaching emotional intelligence, and one of my peers took a 9-minute course and said she learned emotional intelligence, and I was like, that is impossible. And it's like a months and months long process that never ends, really. So I realized I wanted to create a methodology that was very unique and transferable to anyone at any stage of life, that while some of these things that you learn and you walk away from at the event are longer going skill sets that you'll learn, some are things you can absolutely apply instantly in that moment and change your life.
Yeah, and that is what our audience is really looking for. So I think that is so perfect. When we talked, you were very clear that people are going to walk away with things that they can use in their lives immediately, which is brilliant. Yes. But and still have thoughts that are going to germinate and over time are then going to really filter into one's lives. that's perfect.
Correct. Yeah. So there's different levels of this training where it's immediate things that you can apply. And then there are going to be some things where you'll investigate more, you'll research more. I'll plant a seed. And about 6 months later, you're going to be like, oh my gosh, I remember her talking about this, and this all makes sense to me now. And that's the fun part of this type of training and keynote is being able to hit people on those different layers within their conscious and subconscious minds and planting seeds for the future. And so the MORE method is a methodology that basically anyone at any stage of life can apply to up-level their lives. Just quickly, as an overview, the M, to get more of everything good in life, the M stands for mindfulness. So we all have to become more mindful. So I've actually created an auditing system for people to learn to be more mindful, which was a really big challenge, taking something so abstract and bringing it down into tangibility. And the O stands for optimization of body and brain. So I teach people how to really biohack so they can up-level their energy, mental clarity, focus, all the things I think everyone wants, right? And learn how to work smarter instead of harder in a leveraged way. And then the R stands for teaching people how to be more responsive to life than reactive to life. So this is where the emotional intelligence really comes in, teaching mindset control, reframing perspectives, really how to be happier, how to have more inner peace and be a better communicator.
Who doesn't want that?
Who doesn't want that? And lastly, E, I address how to become holistically successful. So there's 4 key quadrants of life that I've identified. That's your success and achievement quadrant, your health and well-being quadrant, your relationship quadrant, and your personal evolution, like who you really keep transforming to be. And a lot of people will focus maybe on their work and they lack their health, and then all of a sudden their health is falling apart, and then their relationships are falling apart, and everything just crashes.
Yeah.
So teaching people how to really nurture these quadrants continuously, equally, so that every day we're feeling more fulfilled by our relationships, by our health, by what we're doing professionally, and by who we are in our own ability of self-love.
Yeah, it sounds like a real holistic approach. You know, one of the tracks that we have at the conference is health and well-being. This definitely is sits right in the center of that, but it also reflects really nicely on personal prosperity, professional success, on family, as you say, with relationships as well, and then entrepreneurship and leadership, because we have so many women who are wanting to move within the industry that they're in, or have started new businesses, or you know, are functioning in that business for quite some time and just want to develop. This is really, this holistic approach is going to touch everyone at every age, as you say. So we can't wait to hear that. To have you on our stage with your energy, and you are such a dynamo. And let's take a step back, because this holistic approach sounds a lot like wellness. You know, that's what my background was in wellness and corporate wellness. Mm-hmm. And, you know, those strategies came from your work as a leader in fitness for quite some time. And then talk to us a little bit about your transition from the fitness industry to more of your lifestyle branding.
Yeah, so my first business was right out of college back in 1995, so I've just outed my age. and by the way, I feel at 46 that I have more energy and vitality than I did at 26 for sure.
Yeah.
So when I was in the fitness industry, I owned a gym in Wilmington, Delaware, and I was a national level fitness competitor, and I worked with Reebok on the aerobics performance team. And why that's important to this conversation is Reebok back then was teaching us influencer marketing in a way that no one had been doing influencer marketing. It wasn't called that back then, but really they realized how do we sell steps and sneakers and slides and make them really have an emotional connection to people to move this movement. Remember, the fitness movement was in its infancy in 1995.
Yeah. Yeah.
So they found master trainers like myself, where we would go out and do these master trainings and speak at these conferences and really humanize the product that really was what they wanted to sell, but in a way that we were the influencers. And having a degree in psychology, this was so fun because it was really putting a lot of application to taking anything that I'm doing. So not just fitness, but anything I'm doing, how do I emotionally connect with my audience?
Yep.
So that I'm branding myself. Really, that's what it's about, personal branding, that then brands your product or service, right?
That applies across all industries. Yep.
Correct. And this is an industry, or I should say this is a time period where personal branding is so important. Even if you work in a company, you should have your own personal brand that people know that you're synonymous with a value proposition.
Right.
And so that fitness stage of my life wasn't just about exercising by any means. I was really learning this holistic approach to personal branding in a way that I saw impact. Like, look at the industry now, right? Yeah. It's, people almost forget 25 years ago, it didn't really exist much. Mm-hmm. And so during that time period, though, I got sick from overtraining, overworking, living East Coast, West Coast, traveling all the time. My nickname is Super Groover. So I was trying to live up to my nickname, forgetting that I was still human, and doing everything I would tell people not to do. Mm-hmm. So, from like a sleeping standpoint, I was like, well, sleep, I don't have time for this. Now I make plenty of time for it.
Yeah.
But so the evolution then started to transition. Life coaching was a new thing. This is in the late 90s. And I got my life coaching certification. And I started taking a lot of my personal training, fitness training clients. And what I was doing in fun with them was pulling out, extracting their greatness. Like, what are you passionate about? What do you really want to do with your life? And that was my gift, is to help people extract their passions and greatness and package it into something. And so I transitioned from that just fitness world into more of this holistic life coaching world. And then I wound up, during this time period, I had a lot of mindset trainers that were my mentors that I had invested a lot in, Bob Proctor being one of the most important ones. If you've ever heard of The Secret, then you would know who Bob Proctor is. Bob then led me to Mark Victor Hansen, Jack Canfield, T. Harv Eker, a lot of other people, Wayne Dyer, who became mentors of mine personally. And this mindset training just took the psychology training I had to a whole different level. And I was helping all these clients start their businesses, and many of them were turning into multi-million-dollar businesses. And I was like, hey,
hello,
consulting fee for this. So I learned a lot more about intellectual property, about licensing, and about how to really invest in businesses, not just consult for businesses.
Yeah.
I helped a lot of companies start on QVC. I became a spokesperson to a lot of brands on QVC, as well as an agent to bringing the brands into QVC. And then eventually I invented my own QVC product, realizing that the best kind of revenue you can have is mailbox money, which means you're making something.
So easy.
And then the money keeps coming when you're sleeping. That was coming from a service-based business.
Yeah.
That was a really important life tipping point for me.
Great. I don't want you to give everything away, because there is so much more to come when you keynote for us on September 19th for the Metro West Conference for Women. So a couple of more questions. This brand that we've created, She's Local, is all about bringing local women together to support each other and connect with each other close to home. Why are you coming to this? Why are you giving everything you've got to make sure that you can be in front of these women? What's the importance to you?
For me, it's to pour into people to expand their potential, to waken people up, to realize that no matter where you came from, you could go wherever you want to go. And I won't share my childhood story here, but I didn't come from this wonderful childhood. I had a lot of odds against me. A lot of traumatic things happened, and I chose to not be a victim. And said, as my good friend and like father role figure to me, Vince Papale always say, instead of being a victim, you become a victor to your circumstances. And that's what I chose to do. And my goal is to really pour into everybody so that they can realize their potential and act on their potential and not waste, life is too short, and not waste time with excuses. And what I love about what you're doing, and I raved about it when I first talked to you, is there's so much power in local community, and a lot of people don't think about how important networking is and how to do it properly too. That's a thing that you're facilitating, which is really important, because I can't tell you how many people say, oh, I go to these networking events and I get nothing out of it. And I say, well, then you're not doing the right thing.
Right.
You're not
meaningful connections. Right. Absolutely.
And also there's an art, and this is a course in of itself, an art of thinking in a transactional way versus a value add way. And the people that walk into these types of events thinking, how do I add value to this, will always get value back.
Yes, that's right. So instead of meeting for a particular purpose, they are there to extend themselves in an honest and authentic way. I love that. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Thank
also,
you. I'm sorry.
Well, I was just going to say, and also asking, not what someone could do for you, but how do you add value to someone else's life? It always comes back. And why, one of my biggest lessons in life came from T. Harv Eker, who, as I mentioned, was a mentor. And I was 25, and he said, your network is your net worth. Physically, mentally, financially, emotionally, your network is your net worth. And I was thrilled because I was such a good networker growing up, but I never knew there was value in it. Hey, if there was a grade in school for that, I would have gotten like straight A's, but I didn't. So it's so important to connect people because you connect currency. And this type of event, you're bringing high level currency together to connect.
I love that. I'm going to use that.
It's the truth.
You're rebranding us too.
I love it.
Thanks, Jen. We're so grateful that you're coming. We can't wait to see you on September 19th. And there are only 50 tickets left. I actually less than 50 now. So we hope people jump in there and get them quickly, because they have got to hear your more method. And can't wait to give you a big squeeze. We really appreciate you coming. We're grateful.
Likewise. I can't wait. I'll see you soon.
See you soon.